most exclusive residence for sale. So you got the riff, and we're going to be continuing our explorations of E, key of E. So you got E, E, and then F sharp, G, G sharp, G sharp, A, B flat, B, B, C sharp, D sharp, E, or E, E, oh sorry, 0, 0, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7, 9, 11, 12, and if you want to do it in octaves, that's what I like, that's where you just put the first finger there, and then you got low F sharp on the second fret of the sixth string, and middle F sharp on the fourth fret of the fourth string, and the side of this finger kind of blocks that fifth string out, so you get this. And I actually like to use my pinky better. It's the great riff. So you got E. I like to start on the E chord. E, E. And then 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it's mostly chromatic. 4, 5, 6, 7, 7, 9, 11, 12. At the end, you skip 7, 9, 11, 12. That's like a major scale. So there's your riff, and then, so just practice that for a while. Here, I'll go slow and you can play it with me. 1, 2, 3, 4. Two. Let's loop it. And then, get to an E. It was the biggest house. A B, and you can play it a bar chord like that. I like to use this F-shaped formation. So it's E, it was the biggest house. And then down a whole tone to an A in the neighborhood. That's the verse. He must have bought this house when he made good. And then it goes to A. 10 bedrooms, D, and a swimming, G on swimming, and back to A. To E. Let's just go from the beginning there. Riff. 1, 2, 3, 4. Bought that house when he made good. A, 10 bedrooms and a swimming pool. Love that part. Love the whole song. Where you entertained all the people that he knew. Bah, bah, bah. And then it goes to the good old Kinksy G sharp. And that's, you know, the same bar chord as you're using here, but on the 4th fret. But he hit the hard times and had to sell out. So G sharp, second bar, and then A, and then an F sharp minor. I'm going to use a full bar chord. Okay. So this is it's a pre-chorus. And he hit the hard times and had to sell out. Chorus. Most exclusive residence for sale. So that's just A, 2, 3, 4, B, A, B. Riff it up. So that's all there is in the song, I think. And let's just play through the second verse. He had to tell all the servants to go away. Bah, 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 bah. Couldn't afford to pay their way. Do one of those there if you want. It took away all the troubles and let him drown. Bah, 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 bah. The judge said to pay up or you must sell out. Most exclusive residence for sale. Good. And I think the only variation is at the end of the song, after the third verse, you get a tag of the chorus, like
most exclusive residence for sale. Bah, bah, bah. Most exclusive residence for sale. Bah, bah,
bah. And then Laz.
La, la.
And it kind of fades out of things. If I was doing a live version, I'd probably do like
la, 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 la.
And then like one of these. If I was doing a live version. If I hadn't become a complete and utter hermit. Okay, so let's try playing along with the recording. And I'm guessing it's going to be really fast. But buckle your seatbelts. Here we go. I'll turn the volume up. I'll get on the first chord. Here we go.
Me.
G sharp. You don't get a lot of time after that riff, eh? I like that, throwing that in the tag. So on the, let's practice that tag.
Get started.
Oh, shut up. Most exclusive residence for sale. 2, 3, 4. Most exclusive residence for sale. La 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 la. Anyway, I think it's two different guitars, and sometimes this one. Dominates, so feel free to just play it with one finger. And the other thing, playing along, you realize these guys are just fueled by amphetamines and going fast, and it's a lot of down. The basic thing sounds like, down, down, like a low, low, high, low, low, high. In the 60s, like if a band plays an A, they have to go like that. It's one of the rules, man. So, anyway, I don't play it like that at all if I'm sitting around. I'm just like more, where's the biggest town? Just really. So I would recommend, just down, down. More chilled out, and that's what I like about these songs. Like a good song, you can kind of just play it however you want. And this riff, just play it like that, or you could play it properly, like open. And that's, I'll teach that really quick. Open, open, 2, 3, 4, 4, open, 5th string, 1st fret, 2nd. So instead of going bum, 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 you go 4, 1, 2. The whole thing could be centered around this finger. I think one guy's kind of playing it like this. other brother's doing. Because you can tell the two instruments have a different timbre. Like, one sounds like it's a lot fuzzier and the other one's kind of clean. So it could be like Dave Davies is playing the big low one on a fuzzy Gibson tone, or whatever he's playing is Flying V or something, and then the other one is on a thin telly. I like the octaves, so I think what more could be taken from the song? Just a truly great song. Just friggin' love it. It's got momentum. Just this most exclusive ballad dance for sale. Like, the song is just trucking along, and he had to pay up or he'd sell out. Most, it's just constantly like traveling to get back to that E. And love it. Face to Face, 1965.